Children, in the previous video, you can see the index error and the correction. Now I will start with the focal to find the focal length of a convex lens. So first step, children, we have to find the rough focal length of the convex lens. So how will I find the rough focal length of the convex lens? So I have placed this convex lens in the clamp stand, and now this is my screen. Okay, so this is my screen, and now I will see through the screen. Right, and I will focus some far off object, like in my lab. Is my window pane is the object. So now I have to move the screen towards the lens so that I can get the clear image of the window pane. So now you can see that as I'm going closer, so this is bad. So you move it again, you have to adjust it such that you should, this is the clear image. Vivek, you can focus, right? So children, this is the clear image of the window pane or the far off trees, you can say that the object is at infinity. So now this screen will be my focus. When you know that, when the object is at infinity, the image forms at the focus. So this is my focus, this is my optical center. So how will you find the focal length? You know, focal length is the distance between the optical center and the focus. Now your optical center, that is my 50, as you can see, this center line you will see of the clamp, this is my 50, and this is at 60, right? So 60 minus 50, that is my focal length will be 10 centimeter. Okay children, so this is the procedure for finding the rough focal length of a convex lens. Focus any far off object, and then so the object is on the left hand side, and I kept my screen on the right hand side, and I moved the screen forward and backward such that I should get the clear image, that will be my focus. Now we have to find the positions at different positions. So say that first I will do, children, first I will do the position at 2F. So I'll place this needle, this will be my one needle, and I have to place the second needle I will place it on the other side, all right, like this. And now I will keep this at 2F. So my 10, as you know that 10 is the 10 is the my 10 centimeter is the rough focal length. So my 2F will be 20. So this is 50. From here I will go 20 centimeter. So that is 60 and 70. All right. So this center point should coincide. So this is my object distance. Now I have to remove the parallax, children. So how will you do? Now see that, children, I will go to the other side now, right? And I will try to remove the parallax. So the first step, children, as I already told you, the tips of the needle should coincide with the center. You'll first check that roughly. You pick it, place your finger or your scale. And now I will move this, okay? And now see, children, in the center of the mirror, you just adjust the height. So as you can see, Vivek, you can focus in the center, please. So as you can see, children, the images are, the tips are overlapping. Okay, so first thing what I have to do, that I will just move it up and down. Okay, I will just move it up and down so that they should just coincide. Okay, so in this case I have to move the lens little upwards, right? And now just move it, right, like this. So I have coincided the tip. There's a screw, you can see that by closing one eye, and there's one side screw, and then I have just moved it such that you can change the plane also in the center. Now I have coincided the tips, you can just see if they are coinciding in the center, right? And now what will I do? Now I'll move my eye to the corner of the lens. See, children, if you move your lens, see Vivek, you can just move your camera across the lens, right? So if you move your camera, so you can see that again the two tips are separated, and at this end also two tips are separated. Now what will I do? I will just close my one eye and Vivek, can you do it from other side? See, can you capture? So now on the other side, if I left hand side, now see children, they are separated. So I'm moving this needle towards the lens. So that gap is decreasing. So at this position towards my left of the lens, the gap has removed. Now I'll focus my eye to the right hand side of the lens. Again the needles are separated. So I'll again move forward. You move forward if the gap is decreasing, and you move in the opposite direction if the gap is increasing. So now you can see that as I'm moving towards the lens, my gap is decreasing. Okay, so they are coincided. Now again I will go to the left hand side. Again the slight gap is there. So again you move it little forward or backward. It's just hit and trial. So see, I'm moving backward. So the gap is decreasing, right? So I have focused it. It's removed. They are coinciding. Again I'll go to the right hand side. Again that gap is there. Again move it forward and backward till it coincide, right? So like this. Now final adjustment, you can do that. You can do little bit of final adjustment with this also. I'm not able to here. I'm just changing the plane little bit. If you can change, right now. So they have to. I can see that now. My both the needles, as I'm moving my eye from left to right across the lens, they are moving together. When they are moving together, that means my parallax is removed. Okay. Now I will note the position. So as you can see that my object is at 70, right? So this is the position of the lens. The position of, we have to note the positions, position of the lens, right? And the position of the object. Now you can take any one of it, the object. You can take this as an object, you can take this as an object. So if I take this as my object, so my position of the object is 70, and the position of the image is, you can see it's 30.2, right? So what is my object distance? My object distance is distance between the lens and the object. So it's 70 minus 50 is 20. And what is my image distance will be, again if you see, is between lens and the image. So this is, again you can say that 50 minus 30.2, that means this is my 19.8. okay, so see children, at 2f your image should form at 2f. I'm just getting a difference of 2 centimeters. So how will you take the next observations, children? Now you have to take 3 observations beyond 2f and 3 observations between f and 2f. So I'll just move this 2 centimeters beyond going by 2 centimeters. So they said this is 71 and this is 72. Okay, so that means I am going beyond 2f, right? So see children, I'll just do once again the same procedure. So what are my steps in the center? So I'm doing the observation at 2f. Again you can see children, so our first step is that in the center the needles, now because see children, I've just moved very little, so my needles are already coinciding in the center. And just this is the main, you can take that as an important point, that you don't have to move the needles after 2f. Now I'll move my eye towards the left hand side. Now you can see there is small gap separation. Okay, and now children, if it is beyond 2f, the image should move between f and 2f. That means now you get a hint, you have to move this forward. Alright, so I am moving this forward and my tips coincided. Now I'll go to the other side. They're already coincided. So see children, when I'm moving from one end to another, again has a slight parallax, slight gap. So I moved. So you can see that as you move your eye together, my needles are moving together. That means my parallax is removed. So what's the important tip I gave you? When you are moving beyond 2f, this needle will move forward. So like this, at an interval of 2 centimeters, you will change the object. Like in this case, I have made 72, you make 74, you make 76, and take 3 observations beyond 2f. and then the three observations between F and 2F. So that means then what you will do, you move your needle, like say 70 was my 2F, so you'll make your object distance 68, right? And while you're making 68, then you know that your image will move beyond. So like this, you have to take the observations, like at 2F, this was at 2F, three observations beyond 2F and three observations between F and 2F. Now we'll put the observation in the observation table. So my lens was at 50, object was at 70 and the image was at 30.2. So if you subtract, what is my object distance? Object distance is distance between lens and the object, so it will be 20 centimeter. And my image distance is distance between lens and the image, it will come out to be 19.8 centimeter. And then children, you have to apply the correction. As you can see that if your correction for my object distance, it was minus 0.7. So you will subtract you will subtract 0.7 from 20. That means it will be 19.7. And that will be the corrected reading. And similarly, from the image distance, you will subtract 0.2. So it will be. So children, you will apply the correction from here. The index correction for u was minus 0.7. So if you subtract minus 7 from 20, it will be 19.3. Okay. And similarly, you will subtract 0.2 from the image distance. So I'll get 19.6. So for every observation, you have to apply the correction for the object distance and the image distance. So like this, you will be taking readings beyond 2F and between F and 2F. From after that, children, you will be plotting the graph between the object distance and the image distance. So see, children, what is the important point here to be note is that the object distance will be on the x-axis and the image distance is on the y-axis, and this will be in the second quadrant, because for my convex lens my u is negative and my v is positive. So this, you have draw it in the second quadrant. First point is this. And the second point, children, you start from 10, please take the scale only. On the x-axis, that is my 1 centimeter is equal to 2, that is 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, like that on the x-axis. Similarly, on the y-axis, you have to start from 10, that is very important point. If you are starting here from 10, you have to start from 10 on the y-axis, that is the image distance, and I am taking the same scale. And children, I have already plotted the points. So you will get your points like this. And now what you have to do, you have to join freehand, you will join these points. And if I join these points, so you can see that how I'm drawing, right? Okay, so let this point is not coming, let it not come on the graph. So you have to draw the graph, and now you have to graph, children. Now from the origin, you will take a, you have to, from the origin, you have to draw a line, right? And like this, you will draw a line, and you have to find the intercept on the y-axis and the x-axis. That means from this line, I have to drop a perpendicular on the x-axis, and similarly, I have to drop a perpendicular on the y-axis. Right? So if you drop a perpendicular on the x-axis and the y-axis, so you can see that what is the intercept on the x-axis. As you can see, intercept on the x-axis is 19.8, and similarly intercept on the y-axis is 19.8. So my focal length is half of the intercept. Now in my case, I am getting my intercept equal, okay, 19.8 by 2, that will be my 9.9 centimeter, right? And children, my focal length was 10 centimeter. So see how closely I found my focal length. And be careful, children, if the intercepts are not equal. Say suppose if my intercept on the y-axis was 20 and my intercept on the x-axis was 19. Sorry, on the x-axis it is 20, on y it is 19. If it is not equal, I am explaining to you that. Then your focal length will be, what you have to do, you will find first the mean of this and then take the half. So I can do 19 plus 20 by 4 I will do. Okay, so that means what I'll get 39 by 4. And what is my 39 by 4? That means 4 9s are 36.3, 4 7s are 28. That means you will get your focal length around 9.8 centimeters. So this you will do, add the two intercepts and divide by 4 when your intercepts are not equal. And if my intercepts are equal, then simply any one of the intercept, either on x or y, divide by 2, that will give you the focal length of the convex lens. Thank you.